Great.
Kamir, thank you so much for coming on the first ever Dastangali podcast. I really appreciate you kind of taking out the time and joining us on this, you know, like this new venture that we're trying to do. So yeah, Kamir, to begin with, I mean, you're such a talented person. और इतनी चीजें आप करते हैं और करते जा रहे हैं अपनी जिंदगी में. आप can you just tell us a little bit about what kind of got you to who you are? अपने आप को कैसे define कैसे करते हैं आप, and how did you get into fashion?
First of all, बहुत शुक्रिया आपको आपका टू आस्क मी टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ योर फर्स्ट पॉडकास्ट. इट्स रियली नाइस टू बी हियर. यार, अपने आप को डिफाइन करना एक बहुत मुश्किल चीज है, बिकॉज अगर अपने आप को ज्यादा डिफाइन करें तो जरा थोड़ी सी एम्बेरसमेंट होती है. बट आई कम फ्रॉम अ वेरी क्रिएटिव फैमिली. आई ग्रो अप इन साउथ पंजाब. एंड मोर और लेस हर कोई ऐसा किसी ना किसी आर्टिस्टिक शोबे से ताल्लुक रखता है. माई मदर वेंट टू आर्ट स्कूल, माई मामू वेंट टू आर्ट स्कूल, माई आंट मेक्स फर्नीचर, माई नानी जिनने काफी मेरी परवरिश की वो भी काफी आर्टिस्टिक थी. तो मैं इस आर्टिस्टिक माहौल में काफी मेरी तरबियत हुई. सो दैट्स वाई आई थिंक आई वॉज ऑलवेज इन टू समथिंग क्रिएटिव. बट I was specifically into clothes always. I don't know why, I don't know how it happened, but ज्यादातर मैं यही कहता हूं कि it's a profession that chose me. मैंने उसे choose नहीं किया, but it's just a profession that chose me from a very early age.
It's incredible, right? Because I mean, I love that you say कि आपकी पूरी फैमिली वॉज इन द क्रिएटिव स्पेसेस, एंड क्रिएटिविटी इज, आई मीन, there's so much creativity in Pakistan, and it's so interesting. I mean, this is something that I did not know about, right? The amount of creativity and the amount of karigari and the amount of like different things that exist in our culture, I had zero clue about, and only I'm now starting to kind of get to know a little bit about. And then from that, I'd love to kind of understand your kind of relationship with Bhawalpur, and then because you said like the architecture and the furniture and the different kinds of creativity that were in your family, choosing one. I mean, choosing in general, मेरे साथ तो बड़े मुझे तो बहुत ही मुश्किल लगता है choose करना कि कोई किस्म की आप passion लें या कुछ भी लें, and you know stick to that and make that your lifeblood and then continue on kind of coming up with new kind of creative forms to express yourself in one medium, right? So choosing working with bridal and working with fabric. And then different element, like one, I'd love to kind of hear your take on this. And second, from Bhawalpur, like Bhawalpur ke bare mein mujhe kuch bhi nahi pata. And I'd love to kind of hear the stories from Bhawalpur you were growing up with that kind of got you to the aesthetic that you have.
I think जहां से आप ताल्लुक रखते हो उसका आपके एस्थेटिक के ऊपर काफी मेजर इन्फ्लुएंस होता है. आई थिंक दैट्स अ ऑब्वियस थिंग. सो बहावलपुर इज इन द साउथ ऑफ पंजाब, यू नो, इट्स द सराइकी बेल्ट. एंड वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंट इन्फ्लुएंसेस ओवर देयर इन टर्म्स ऑफ क्राफ्ट. इट इज काइंड ऑफ अ हब ऑफ क्राफ्ट. अगर आप ब्लॉक प्रिंटिंग को देखते हैं, बहुत सी हैंड एम्ब्रॉयडरीज उधर होती हैं, फ्रॉम शैडो वर्क टू कच्चा टांका. फिर चुनरी भी उधर होती है, गोटे का काम भी उधर होता है. सो अ सर्टन बोल्डनेस ऑफ एस्थेटिक, अ सर्टन एलिमेंट ऑफ फोक दैट आई गेट फ्रॉम देयर. एंड ऑल्सो इन माई फैमिली, यू नो, आई एम अ बॉर्न इन द 70s एंड अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ वुमेन हु काइंड ऑफ were at their peak of expressiveness in terms of what they wore in the 70s. So my aunts and my mothers would wear ghagras with their boots and their sweaters. So I grew up in an environment where traditional clothes were always being incorporated either in a formal way but also in an informal daily way into clothing. So you know, काफी glamorous women थी मेरे इर्द गिर्द, so that was always inspiring. Then my nanny was very relaxed and easy going, कि जो कुछ करना है कर सकते हो. So I was like kind of cutting up her sarees when I was a little boy. She'd open something और उसके अंदर एक सुराख होता था, and then I would have made something out of it. If I asked for Barbie dolls, my mother said sure, no problem. So I suppose you can have some sort of a interesting thought and comments on nature versus nurture, because I think I got plenty of both. A, there's a creative streak as far as visual artistry as well as writing. My nani's brother, who's quite a famous Urdu novelist and a travelogue writer called Muhammad Khalid Akhtar. Wow. So he was always around. And then another brother of my nani's was like kind of a wannabe scientist who was always trying to make gold and like work in different elements of alchemy. So I grew up with very colorful characters, and as a result, imagination was something that was encouraged and allowed to flourish. Dusra ek ye bhi bahut hota hai ki jab aap 80s mein ek chote se shahar mein apni zindagi guzar rahe ho, to you have to kind of amuse yourself. You are not reliant on, you know, the screen the way people are today. So, you know, there was just a lot of time on my hands and a lot of books in the shelves that I used to read. And I was a crafty kid who was always making something with his hands. And there was just, I mean, simply by virtue of the fact that it was a sleepy town in South Punjab, I was just making a lot of stuff from an early age.
आजकल के जमाने में ये मसला है ना कि हम सब लोग स्क्रीन्स के ऊपर ही होते हैं. Like I have 3 screens active right now on me. तो एक सेकंड नहीं हमारा गुजरता जहाँ पे हम बोर नहीं होते. और जितनी आप वो सोचते हैं कि यार जब मैं बोर होता हूँ मेरा दिमाग चलता था, एंड देन व्हाइल आई वाज गेटिंग बोर्ड आई वुड स्टार्ट मेकिंग अप स्टोरीज टू काइंड ऑफ
Right.
Entertain yourself, right? And that's where the creative brain kind of starts to really flourish and right, kind of get into gear. Wo aajkal ke zamane mein I don't see that as much. I mean, I see my nieces and my nephews. I mean, they're pretty creative, but they're limited on like TV time. Milega khali ek ghante ka milega. Uske baad fir like you know you have to come up with your.
I think you have to also kind of move with the times. I mean, on a positive note, the young people of today are very adept in the digital medium.
Yeah.
It's not like they're being uncreative with it. I mean, you'll find a lot of people that are only taking selfies, but a lot of people are exploring photography, you know, exploring ideas, trying to have dialogue and conversations. So there are different narratives going on within that medium as well. So I'm not one of those people who will just sit there and poo-poo it. But thing for artistic development, in my case, a certain bit of isolation and loneliness and just a lot of time on my hands has been beneficial, for sure.
So, Kamya, I'd love to kind of hear, when you have characters like these growing up, what were some of the stories that were told to you? Like, purane zamane ki, ya to, like, jo kahaniyan nahi hoti, jo humare khandan mein ek bande se, dusre bande se, dusre bande se, dusre bande se, like, are given away.
Right.
I mean, growing up, I had this, my mom used to tell me this, I don't even know how to say it anymore, but it was this Godu Modu ki kahani to like put me to sleep. Aur ek kahawat hoti thi that she would come and tell me to wake me up, which was like, jaldi utho, aankhein kholo, itna sona theek nahi hai, waqt ka khona theek nahi hai. You know, these like small little things that we have growing up. I'd love to kind of hear.
Well, I mean, we had a lot of reading, and one of our uncles used to serialize stories for us. And, you know, there was H. Rider Haggard's story, She, about the goddess in the forest. So I remember that there was a lot of, like, you know, he used to leave us with cliffhangers, do it in sections and parts and do it as a serial. So that used to be very fun. And lots of family stories, you know, some too personal to tell, but everybody was always telling a tale. But yes, the conversation hamesha kafi vibrant thi, and sense of humor family ka kafi acha tha. And I still think to this day, wit and humor is very important to any form of creativity.
Yeah.
Even design mein thoda sa, there should be something that makes you smile. Thodi si ada mein aisi hona chahiye ki wo ek hasmukh si feeling de aapko. You know, sanjeeda kaam bhi mujhe bahut pasand hai, magar thodi si lightness aur thodi si irreverence, again, that comes from the family as well.
Like a playfulness, you know? Almost.
Yeah.
And so, you know, when the work that you do, right? Like working with bridal, there are so many different traditions that are in when you encompass ke shaadi karna kya hota hai, shaadi ke maine kya hote hain, what kind of clothing, the colors, and all of these different things. How has the evolution of what a wedding dress is to you, how has that kind of evolved? Or has it evolved?
I'd say in my earlier part of my career, I wasn't such a traditionalist. But over time, I have become somebody who innovates within the traditional parameter. Because, as you have said, people's talent and technical ability with so many different techniques, especially, especially in embellishment, because you see where the north and the north of India always had the craft in this area coming down from Kashmir, where you have the finest embroideries. And then, you know, in the north, you had a lot of tankas. So we managed to retain them and our workers are quite skilled. So I think that it's quite foolish as a designer and a little irresponsible to completely let that go and not incorporate it into one's work. And ek aur hamari family mein kafi design ability ye hai ki hum rangon ke sath kafi khelte hain. So, you know, I like ornamentation, I like embroidery. So I thought it was a good area for me to go because at the end of the day, ye log kapde ceremonial hote hain. So I don't even like to say so much bridal because hamari shaadi mein bhi itni farak ceremonies hoti hain. Nikah ka joda ho sakta hai, shaadi wale din ka joda ho sakta hai, valime wale din ka joda ho sakta hai, milad sharif ka joda ho sakta hai, maiyon ka joda ho sakta hai, mehndi ka joda ho sakta hai. I mean, for a designer to be in the matrimonial sphere, mashallah se itne zyada ceremonies hoti hai that you can kind of fit into everything. So, isliye I actually find it not a limiting thing. कई दफा हमारे जर्नलिस्ट और कई लोग कहते हैं कि यार तुम तंग नहीं आ जाते, डोंट यू वांट टू मेक समथिंग मॉडर्न या वेस्टर्न कपड़े बनाओ, बट आई थिंक विद इन द ब्राइडल स्फीयर देयर इज सो मच वैरायटी इन टर्म्स ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन दैट आई डोंट नो अबाउट एनीबॉडी एल्स बट आई एम कॉन्स्टेंटली स्टिल एंगेज्ड because there's so much to do. Aur phir agar aapko zara thoda sa history ka shauk ho, thoda sa world culture ka shauk ho, apne travels ko incorporate karne ka shauk ho, jaise Egypt gaye to wahan se kuch apne zehen mein kar liya, aur I'm half Persian as well, so I have family that lives in Shiraz in Iran. My father and three of my siblings, half siblings, live there. So my travels over there influenced me a lot. So I like ethnicity, and ethnicity just doesn't have to be South Asian ethnicity. It can be from your surrounding countries. And I think multiculturalism is something that is also very interesting to me in terms of my clothes and in terms of jo main patterns istemal karna chahta hoon. यानी कि मुझे बहुत मजा आता है कि अगर मैं किसी स्पेनिश चीज और मेक्सिकन चीज को किसी इजिप्शियन चीज के साथ, बहावलपुरी चीज के साथ और ईरानी चीज के साथ, सारों के साथ मिक्स करके कुछ नया बनाऊं. सो ओवर द इयर्स आई हैव बीन टोल्ड आई हैव बिकम मोर अडेप्ट एट इट बिकॉज टाइम एंड एक्सपीरियंस ऑल्सो काउंट्स फॉर अ लॉट. बट हमेशा there are multi-layered in terms of not just silhouette but also in terms of embellishment and color. I always like trying to put elements jo logon ko aise lage ki ikatthe nahi jate, but mera khayal se designer ka kaam hi ye hota hai ki un elements ko balance kare. Or you know, it's almost like a percentage. You have to think ke इतनी परसेंट कोई चीज में वेरिएबिलिटी होनी चाहिए, मगर इतनी परसेंट किसी चीज में फिनेस और क्राफ्ट होना चाहिए, और फिर एक परसेंटेज होता है सरप्राइज का कि किसी जोड़े में, किसी आउटफिट में वो एलिमेंट ऑफ सरप्राइज क्या है जो उसको एक ऑर्डिनरी चीज या ब्यूटिफुली मेड और एक अप्रोप्रिएट चीज से थोड़ी सी एलिवेट करे और उसको जरा एक सॉर्ट ऑफ स्लाइटली अनएक्सपेक्टेड डायरेक्शन में लेकर जाए. तो इस किस्म की चीजों से मुझे काफी दिलचस्पी है कि ट्विस्ट क्या होना चाहिए. There should always be some sort of a twist.
It's almost like a grand closing as well, right? Like what I love, जो आपने अभी बात करी है, you're a storyteller. You're essentially with what you're saying, with what you're doing. ये सब कपड़े जो आप बना रहे हैं, जहाँ से आप inspiration लेकर आ रहे हैं, you're just bringing all of those together and you're forming a story that you're presenting in a way and in a medium that is a fabric, that is something to be enjoyed, that is something to be shared. Right at the end of the day,
I wish I was modest enough to say that you have not hit the nail on the head, but you have. It is a response jo ke mujhe kafi milta hai ki aapke kapdon mein ek kahani hoti hai hamesha, aur mera khayal se har visual medium mein kahani hoti hai. Ab I wouldn't be so pompous as to say that fashion design is art, magar there is certainly an art to it. You require some artistry and some skill to make it. So, and then that means ke phir ek narrative hota hai har cheez ka, ek painting ka hota hai, kitab ka obviously hota hai. So I think kapdon mein bhi agar aap apne aap ko designer kehte hain, so then there has to be some narrative, koi point of view, kuch to aap kehna chahe na. सिर्फ कपड़े भी हैं, मगर कपड़े भी कुछ कहते हैं, हमारे बारे में कुछ कहते हैं, बनाने वाले इंसान के बारे में भी कुछ कहते हैं. So they do have something to say, for sure.
100%. And it's just, it's also very enlightening and beautiful for me to see कि आप, I honestly agree with you कि the wedding sphere is not a small sphere at all. You know, it's one of
no,
the most
not.
Important days for majority of our lives, for a lot of people. और उसमें इतनी खुशी होती है, जो हम इतनी खुशी से एक साथ इकट्ठे होते हैं और बैठते हैं, नाचते हैं, गाते हैं. We all come together and you know what? Like we have some of the most beautiful kind of traditions that are involved in शादियों में. Like अब मैं अपने दोस्तों की शादी पे जाता हूँ. Like if it's a wedding from a Westerner, it's like a one day affair, you have a reception and you're done. But then when you go to a Pakistani wedding, I mean, I just got married in March of this year, Corona kind of pani paid, like jo Karachi mein jo barishon ho rahi hai wahi baat shaadi pe bhi ho gayi.
Congratulations on your wedding.
Thank you very much. But the idea ke maiyon hain, nikah hai, aur ye sab henna hai, mehndi, you know, where we all kind of come together and these colorful dresses kind of come about and people kind of come about to celebrate this union of people, I think it's beautiful. And then when you're telling me ki aap jahan jahan se inspiration laake, you're creating that narrative kind of, we live in this extremely globalized world and you're bringing all of that together, right, into these events that where people are coming together, Pakistani shadi ho, jahan marzi ki shadi ho, like jab log saath aa rahe hain, and you're really sharing that moment with each other, I think it's the best moment to kind of, you know, happily tell a story of this union. So I really agree with you, Kate. You know, you can never be limited in
yeah, your... I mean, because as you said, it's an opportunity. Like if each different occasion aapke liye ek wo opportunity hoti hai kuch express karne ke liye, and har occasion ke jo jode hote hain unka ek apna mood hota hai aur usme fir aap apne elements incorporate kar lete hain. Like also then mixed race, multiracial marriages can also be very interesting for a designer. Like recently I made a joda for a lovely lady who got married to a Chinese gentleman, and we mixed South Asian motifs with like Asian motifs, like the phoenix and the dragon, which sort of represent good luck and prosperity, with South Asian motifs, and that amalgamation becomes very interesting as well. So because it's a bespoke business where I do custom made to order, there's a lot of like fun interaction, and you kind of become, not, I wouldn't go so far as to say that you kind of become a family member for the experience of it, but you definitely sort of become this uncle / family doctor who's kind of solving all these design problems for the whole family.
Juraj, and that is, WhatsApp ke reply kar raha hai messages pe.
हाँ तो वो भी उसका एक हिस्सा बनता है कि जो आप अपने स्टूडियो का और अपने सेल्स पीपल की जो एनवायरनमेंट और मूड क्रिएट करते हैं वो भी जरा हसमुख और खुश मिजाज, बिसाइड्स फॉर बीइंग एफिशिएंट, बट इट शुड फील लाइक अ वेरी सेफ एंड कंफर्टेबल प्लेस वेयर एवरीबॉडी कैन जस्ट रिलाई ऑन यू. बिकॉज जैसे आपने कहा कि शादियों में खुशी का भी बहुत मौका होता है और लोग बहुत एंजॉय भी करते हैं, बट स्ट्रेसफुल भी काफी होता है बिकॉज माशाल्लाह हमारे यहाँ मल्टीपल इवेंट्स होते हैं. सो इफ योर यू नो द फैमिली दैट यू आर वर्किंग फॉर, इफ दे आर गोइंग क्रेजी एंड बिजर्क, माय प्लेस शुड बी द प्लेस दे कम वेयर दे लाइक यू नो रिलैक्स्ड एंड फील टेकन केयर ऑफ. दैट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू. And that's how then you kind of become a part of a family story because they come back again and you kind of become a figure in their life. And I really enjoy that because I don't think that you can do this sort of made to order business if you don't like people.
100%. It's all
that's
about
fundamental.
Yeah. Exactly. It's a fundamental thing. Relationships pe hi based hoti hai.
Exactly.
I'd be curious, Kamyar, to see ke, have you created a tradition or do you have traditions that you kind of encapsulate in your work or in your life from a young age to today, whether it be something that you do with your clients, something that you do personally before you kind of do a collection?
Well, I mean, we're quite a courtly culture in any case. And, you know, a lot of families who are very correct, once they finalize their order, they will come with their mithai. And you know, once you start something, there is sort of like a bismillah and a mithai kind of situation. So that is a tradition. But more than tradition, it kind of rhymes with tradition, is to listen. You know, my modi operandi and generally approach or jis tarah se main kaam shuru karta hu is ke pehle aap dusre ki khas taur pe apni client ki baat sune. You know, my tradition is to ask the girl that when you were a little girl, what did you imagine yourself looking like when you were a bride? Like, you know, because har kisi ke khwab hote hain, har kisi ki koi fantasy hoti hai. So my personal tradition is try to sort of get to what a person's fantasy is. And then, you know, it sounds like a cliche, make it a reality, but come somewhere in the middle where I can incorporate my aesthetic and point of view into it or unki ख्वाहिश और उनकी फैंटेसी को मेल्ड करके कुछ पेश किया जाए.
I mean, it's a very difficult job that you do, you know, क्योंकि जो expectation आपकी होती है और फिर expectation को storytelling से mix करना और अपनी भी अंदर like perspective डालना, which is why they're coming to you. It's a very difficult and a very fine line.
Kai dafa it takes a actual literal sort of practical direction as well. Bahut si ladkiyan hoti hain jo apni ammi ka dupatta ya apni ammi ka gharara lekar aayengi aur fir hame uske sath koi nayi cheez banani hoti hai ya in-laws apni koi purani multi-generational cheez denge. Like recently I made my friend Meera Sethi's bridal and her mother came with a pura sandook jisme unki nani ki par nani ki fabrics the aur you know pattiyan thi. It was like a treasure trove that we dived into and then used and incorporated. So you literally sort of do get involved in some cases with people's family history.
Wow. I mean, I can't even like imagine jo the stories that you must hear sitting down with people that are coming, dadi par dadi ke kapde aur cheeze, like the time.
Yeah, you froze up for a second, but you're back.
The time that these elements, you know, that they've had, like dadi ya par dadi, jisne bhi ye cheeze rakhi hongi shaadi ke liye. It's just incredible to see the amount of love and care that people put into this, right? So,
I mean, it's a very cultural thing to start collecting for your daughter. You know, I think the minute a daughter is born in South Asia, एंड आई थिंक ये भी एक खूबसूरत बात है कि उसके लिए चीजें इकट्ठी होनी शुरू हो जाती हैं, एक संदूक बन जाता है जिसमें साड़ियां जाती हैं, शॉल्स जाती हैं, ज्वेलरी शुरू होती है, कटलरी, क्रॉकरी, ब्यूटीफुल ऑब्जेक्ट्स, कार्पेट्स, यू नो, थिंग्स स्टार्ट गेटिंग अक्यूमुलेटेड. सो वो इज अ पार्ट ऑफ आवर ट्रेडिशन. नई चीजें भी बनती हैं, बट आई थिंक बचपन से ही द sort of the thought of a true soul is very prevalent.
I didn't even know that. I mean, is that something that's deeply intertwined with a lot of people? Ke bachpan se?
Yeah, I'd say a lot of people start collecting for their daughter's marriage. It is very much a cultural, you know, I hate to use the word burden, but getting your child married off in Pakistan is something that you think about the minute you have that kid.
Oh, wow.
And with girls, especially because there's so many ceremonies and, you know, a cultural expectation of a certain degree of ornamentation. Because achhi baat ho ya buri baat ho, South Asia mein kisi ko simple cheez nahi chahiye. So they do... you know, एक तो खुद अपनी पर्सनल पसंद भी होती है, मगर एक सेरेमनी होती है तो सारों के बारे में भी सोचना होता है. लाइक दूल्हा दुल्हन कई दफा बेचारे कंप्लेन करते हैं कि ये तो बाकी लोगों की शादी हो रही है, व्हाट अबाउट अस. सो समटाइम्स देयर कैन बी मेनी कुक्स, बट देन आई थिंक के इट्स नाइसर दैट सो मेनी पीपल केयर रादर देन नोबडी केयर.
100%.
यू नो,
100%.
So there is that.
Kamya, kind of coming out of your work and your everyday life, I'd love to kind of hear about some of the stories that resonate most about Pakistan with you, or something that you've kind of grown up hearing, or what's like your most vivid memory of growing up. Or,
you know, as a young person, my vivid memory is of a rural Pakistan, which I adore. I think, though we are a society which is extremely divided in terms of class, and there's a lot of contrast, but I've grown up in villages, running in wheat fields, running in cotton fields, playing with my friends in the village, listening to folk music, live folk music. One of my earliest memories is one of my mamu's weddings where Pathane Khan, the incredible folk singer, came to perform. It was just amazing. So I've always loved local indigenous culture, and that is very much a part of my growing up. And of course, it's influenced the work. But those are my favorite things about Pakistan, from sort of east to west to the south. I mean, I really think that this country has itni khubsurti hai idhar, itni diversity hai idhar, itna khubsurat craft hai, itna khubsurat and mazedar produce hai. I mean, you know, our fruit can only really be compared to, say, fruit in Iran, which is kind of also very delicious. But, you know, our fruit is so delicious, and there's so much diversity within Pakistan. So natural beauty is always a part of my memory bank. Jab hum chote hote the, to hum बहुत elaborate picnics में जाते थे, desert में, you know, South Punjab is the Cholistan that meets Rajasthan in India. So we used to go for like 3-day camping trips when we were little, drive my nani's brother's rocky jeeps in the afternoon when he wasn't aware, and go dune bashing on sand dunes. So yeah, and swim in the canal. I remember lots of swimming in the canal. So yeah, I've had a really amazing outdoorsy existence when rural life kafi rural hoti thi. Ab, you know, achhi baat hai, we are a highly populated country, and what I think is the positive aspect of our high population is that it's 60% young people, and I think in the next 10 years that's going to have some positive effects on our society, I hope. You know, positivity is, and development and moving with the times is always an important thing.
I think our population is very young.
Yeah,
like, aapki
but
average,
I do
hamari
have a
age
nostalgia for the actual rural life, you know.
For sure. So, if you were to describe what Pakistan is and what Pakistan is to you, I mean, you've done it anyways. Lekin, what would be something that you would tell to someone who's never been to Pakistan, who's never heard of Pakistan, who has that standard narrative that people look at on CNN and BBC and things?
I think ये तो काफी एक आसान बात है. एक तो natural beauty है और लोग बड़े अच्छे हैं. Like there's a warmth and a hospitality that I think we have, which is you know, very enjoyable. The people are warm. Mehman nawazi hai. So I would tell people, and there's a sort of you know, it's really quite beautiful. Yes, it's shocking for the Western audience to see the stark contrast between living standards. However, people are just really warm across the board.
Yeah.
Whether they be economically challenged or whether they be affluent, there's a certain sort of warmth that I really think is quite nice.
Completely agree. I mean, I remember ek dafa main ja raha tha, we did a road trip from Islamabad to Chitral. And on that road trip, we stopped over for like a couple of minutes. I don't know what the issue was. Maybe there was an issue with the car at Shandur Top, near Shandur ke pas kahin. And there were a couple of police officers that like were helping us with the car. And they're like, you're not leaving. Hamare saath baithe hain, chai piye. Like, we went inside and we sat down. And we had like an hour and a half long conversation about them, about their sons and their daughters. And we just sat and we had chai. And then we were, you know, like they helped us fix the car. And then we were on our way. And you at first think, yeah, ye to police hai ya army hai, haath mein AK-47 hai, koi bandook pakdi hai. But then they're making chai for you on the stove. And then, you're chilling with these guys who don't know you, but now are welcoming you as if they're your family, that you've known them forever, right?
Absolutely. People are great. And and even though it's quite prevalent, magar har waqt ek surprise lagta hai ki dekho kitne achha tha. You know, ye aur baat hai ki kuch log jo ke nahi achhe unke bare mein main baat nahi kar raha. Mere khayal se zara achhe logon ke bare mein baat zyada karni chahiye aur dusre logon ke bare mein kam sochna chahiye.
Yeah.
Magar by and large log bahut achhe hain.